Hello friends, in this video we'll study some rules to determine the point group of any structure. Here initially, for determining the point group, first you have to check the presence of principal axis of rotation. If the principal axis of rotation is absent, then there may be possibility of these three point groups C1, CS or CI depending on the presence of center of symmetry and the horizontal plane of symmetry. If CN is absent and only E is present, your point group will be C1. For example, lactic acid, here only rotation is possible at 360 degrees, nothing else is possible. So only E is present. If CN is absent and E and sigma H is present, then your point group will be CS. And if E and I, center of inversion I, is present, then your point group is CI. So based on the presence of I and sigma H, you will get the point group if the principal axis of rotation is absent. If principal axis of rotation is present, then point group will be CN. After presence of principal axis, if you have to find the presence of C2 axis, and if there are n C2 which are perpendicular to CN, if it satisfies this rule, then your point group, instead of CN, it will become DN. Then you have to find out the presence of plane. If only sigma V is present, then your point group will be CNV. If sigma V and sigma H both are present, then your point group will be sigma NH. Only V is present, then it will be sigma NV, a CNV. And if it is sigma H present, even though sigma V is present, then your point group would be CNH. If sigma D is present, if D is present, it will satisfy this value, as we had discussed in the definition that NC2 is perpendicular to CN, then there are sigma D. So point group will become C and D. If this is present, NC of D is perpendicular, sigma D is absent, sigma H present, sigma D is absent, then the point group will be D and H. It may not be possible that every time there is sigma D or NC2 perpendicular to CN. But if it is absent, then point group will be DNS. In certain molecules, based on the shape, their point group will be determined. So if the shape is tetrahedral, then their point group will be TD. If it is an octahedral, it has an OH point group. Now, if the molecule is linear, then the point group will be, if it is inversion of present, then point group will be C infinity N. And if there is absent of inversion, center of inversion, then the point group will be C infinity V. Now, molecules which have CN proper axis of rotation, they have only N minus 1 distinct symmetry elements, because the nth will be the original and the point group will be CN. For example, H2O2, CO2, in this structure, the number of rotations will be N minus 1 because nth will be the original. Point group will be CNV when CN axis and sigma V plane is present. For example, H2O, there is C2V, and for ammonia, NH3, it is C3V because there is CN axis of rotation and plane of symmetry sigma V. If there is presence of sigma H, horizontal plane of symmetry along with CN axis, for example trans 1,2-dichloroethylene, then the point group of this trans 1,2-dichloroethylene is C2H. And if there is a rotational group and NC2 rotational axis only, then the point group will be DN. That is not our concern for this particular syllabus. This is the classification. You can find it out how to determine any point group based on various rules that we studied, various presence of plane, perpendicular axis, etc., etc. So these are the rules of to determine particular point group of any structure. You have to follow these rules, and every structure has a definite point group. Thank you.